the coronavirus emergency and a reality check on how concerned you should be and what you should really do to protect yourself and your family. We're seeing a rush to buy those face masks, and TJ Holmes is here with more on that. Good morning, TJ.
All right, let me try to make it plain here, Stray. I have one surgical face mask here between the two of us, between me and Tom. He's sick, I'm not. Who should get the mask? Well, your natural instinct is to say, give me that mask. I don't want to catch what he has, but I should be begging him to wear it, because him, the sick person wearing it, better protects me, the healthy person, as if I were wearing it myself. So all these masks are floating around out there. Which ones do health officials say you should use? None of them.
As coronavirus fears sweep the country, many are turning to protective face masks, hoping to keep the germs away. Gwyneth Paltrow, Selena Gomez, and Kate Hudson among those posting pictures of their face coverings while traveling. But not all masks are created equal, and the surgical face masks that many people are turning to for protection from coronavirus likely won't protect you, according to health officials. These types of masks instead are recommended for people who are already sick, because they're designed to prevent a person from spreading germs from sneezing and coughing. But there's another type of mask called an N95 or respirator mask, which the FDA says has a very efficient filtration, keeping out 95% of airborne particles. But health officials only recommend these for healthcare professionals who are in constant contact with sick patients.
I think people see a mask and they see an illusion of protection, that if they put the mask on, it'll somehow block viruses from getting into their mouth or nose when they breathe. That's just not the case. Anyone who does not have a respiratory illness, meaning a cough or sneezing, should not be wearing any type of mask, whether it's a surgical mask or a respirator.
But that hasn't stopped the public from buying up masks. Stores and websites sold out. ABC News gaining exclusive access inside this 3M factory in South Dakota, where they're working around the clock to meet demand. Amazon even reportedly warning third-party retailers that are taking advantage of this mask hysteria, raising prices by more than 400%. Health officials are preparing for a potential shortage.
The masks should be for the healthcare workers. The public should not be buying masks.
And believe it or not, by wearing a mask, you could be putting yourself at even more risk.
People do not use their masks correctly. They play with it. They wear it too long. They rub their nose underneath it.
You hear that, folks? You could be making it worse by wearing a mask, putting yourself at greater risk, because what do you do all day? You're doing exactly what they tell you not to do. You're touching your face all day and getting sick. Let's put this graphic up that got a lot of attention. People had a lot of fun with it, but it's from the CDC. It's an official graphic from the CDC that shows all these different facial hair styles and telling men how this could actually keep you from wearing your respirator correctly. I mean, there's a side whiskers, a mutton chops, a Zorro style, a soul patch. They have all this. But folks, this was put out years ago. This was not for coronavirus. It is for people who actually do work in industries where they need to wear respirators. So that's a serious graphic. It made the rounds. It kind of confused people, like, so we need to pay attention to this? But it does, Dr. Jen is going to speak to this, it does show the seriousness of this matter of wearing these masks the right way.
Mm-hmm. 100%.
And Dr. Jim, welcome back. And we talked about how sick people should wear the mask.
Yeah.
But outside of sick people, there are some others who should be wearing a mask. And who are they?
Yeah, so we remember, and Robin, when you had your stem cell transplant, you know, if someone is a transplant patient, they have a weakened immune system. Of course, that's going to be individual case-by-case basis, you know, to wear a mask. That is a very small percentage of people. Okay, as TJ said, we use surgical masks in hospital settings or even, you know, out in the public on sick people. Okay, viral particles, coronavirus and influenza, to name two, go right through that mask. Okay, so if you say, well, then why is it helpful in preventing this way? Because people coughing, sneezing, spewing large particles out into the room, of course, that's a barrier, but they can go right in. That's why they're not helpful. What I want to show you guys is these N95 respirators. There are a bunch of different styles. These are what we use in hospital settings for healthcare providers. They have to be measured for your face. I went through this process. It took several attempts, different sizes, different models, to actually find the one that works for me. They have to be put on properly. You see the two elastic bands there. One has to be high on the head, one has to be around the neck. We're seeing people wear these incorrectly. These are not for lay public use.
I know it drives you crazy when you see the video and people are wearing them incorrectly.
Yeah, and to be clear, Robin, if people really get sick with anything, not just coronavirus, and they can't go to a hospital and have healthy healthcare workers take care of them, we're in a much bigger situation.
Something to keep in mind.
Yep.